हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, हर घर पाठशाला में आपका स्वागत है। माई सेल्फ राजेश नंदा, लेक्चरर इन फिजिक्स, प्रेजेंटली पोस्टेड एट गवर्नमेंट मॉडल सीनियर सेकेंडरी स्कूल कोटली। तो आज के टॉपिक की शुरुआत करने से पहले छोटा सा मार्गदर्शन कि अपने आप को किस तरीके से मोटिवेटेड रखना है स्टडी के लिए। प्यारे बच्चों, इसके लिए आपको प्रतिदिन जो भी वीडियो भेजे जाते हैं आपने उन्हें ध्यानपूर्वक देखना है। प्लीज वॉच द वीडियो केयरफुली, बट द टीचर इज सेइंग यू हैव टू वॉच दैट केयरफुली एंड देन प्रिपेयर द नोट्स फ्रॉम दैट वीडियो। जो भी आपने देखा उसमें क्या देखा, क्या सुन रहे हैं आप, क्या समझ रहे हैं, उसके नोट्स बनाएं और नोट्स को एडिट करें, उसके मेन पॉइंट्स को हाईलाइट करें, आउटलाइन द मेन पॉइंट ऑफ दैट नोट्स, देन इंटीग्रेट द नॉलेज। जो भी नॉलेज आपने गेन किया वहां पर उसे इंटीग्रेट करें। आप बुक्स की हेल्प लें, इंटरनेट की हेल्प लें, साथियों की हेल्प लें, टीचर की हेल्प लें, उस नॉलेज को इंटीग्रेट करने के लिए, इकट्ठा करने के लिए। देन आस्क द क्वेश्चन from that topic which you have written, ask the question from yourself, what is there, how is there, what the teacher have taught you, what he want to ask, then ask the friends, apne doston se baat kare ki aapne kya sikha aaj, ya maine ye sikha, kya maine ye sahi sikha ya galat sikha, इस बारे में आपस में डिस्कशन करें। डिस्कशन से आपकी लर्निंग इंप्रूव होती है। देन आस्क द टीचर व्हाट एवर योर क्वारी, यू आस्क योर टीचर थ्रू टेलीफोन। आप टेलीफोन करें, उन्हें मैसेज करें, टेक्स्ट करें, ईमेल करें, व्हाट्सएप करें। आपका कोई भी क्वेश्चन अनआंसर्ड नहीं रहना चाहिए। आपको डेली जो भी आपके मन में जो भी टॉपिक रिलेटेड क्वेरीज हैं वो उसी दिन डाउट क्लियर हो जाना चाहिए। Then most important thing is prepare a timetable and follow that timetable, a good timetable. आप एक अच्छा सा timetable बनाएं। ये एक बहुत ही best way है learning का। One of the best way to learn any subject is following well-planned timetable. And the physics require daily practice and regular attention of the students. Students are suggested to create the timetable and follow that strictly. आप timetable बनाएं, उसे follow करें, उसमें से कोई भी time आपका gap नहीं पड़ना चाहिए। आप routine में study करें, okay? Then come to today's topic, that is magnetism. And in the magnetism, we will discuss the atom as a magnetic dipole. And along with that, we will discuss the magnetic field. Before discussing the today's topic, let us revise the previous topic. Previous lecture we have studied. In the previous lecture, we have studied that what happen if a bar magnet is cut into the two pieces, transverse to length and along its length. When we cut a bar magnet transverse to its length, pole strength of each new magnet is same as that of original magnet, but magnetic moment is half because the length is half. And when we cut along the length, pole strength of each new magnet is half the pole strength of original magnet, and magnetic moment is also half as the length remain same. Then we have discussed the current loop as a magnetic dipole and magnetic dipole moment. For that we have considered a magnetic loop and of current I is flowing through that, and that loop have the area of cross section A. Then magnetic dipole moment of current loop, that is given as M is equal to IA unit vector, and the SI unit of magnetic dipole moment, that is ampere meter square. When we look at any side, any one side of the loop carrying the current, current is in clockwise direction, then that side of loop behave like the magnetic north, and if the current is in clockwise direction, then that side behave like the magnetic south pole. It is found that magnetic dipole moment of loop is directly proportional to current flowing through the loop, and magnetic dipole moment is directly proportional to area of cross section of the loop. Then combining these two, magnetic moment is directly proportional to IA, or M is equal to KIA, where K is constant of proportionality, and constant of proportionality is found to be equal to 1 when current is measured in ampere and area in meter square, and then the magnetic dipole moment is ampere meter square and is given as M is equal to IA. Since upper face of loop behave like a north pole and lower face south pole, magnetic dipole moment act perpendicular to the plane of the loop in upward direction. If A is area vector, representing the area vector, then the equation may be expressed as the magnetic dipole moment vector is equal to IA vector. Then today's topic, that is atom as a magnetic dipole. In an atom, electron revolve around the nucleus in the closed orbit. Since electron is charged particle, so its orbit around the nucleus is equivalent to the current loop. When electron revolve in the anti-clockwise direction, the current is clockwise. Thus, the upper face of the electron loop that act as a south pole and lower face act as a north pole. Thus, an atom behave like the magnetic dipole. Then we discuss about the magnetic dipole moment of a revolving electron. Let us calculate the magnetic dipole moment of atom due to orbital motion of electron. For that, suppose that an electron of mass ME and charge E revolve in the circular orbit of radius R around the positive nucleus in clockwise direction with velocity V. This is represented here is an electron having mass ME, radius R of this circular orbit, and velocity of electron, that is V. Then the angular momentum of electron due to the orbital motion, that is given as L is equal to ME VR. From the sense of orbital motion of electron as in the figure, angular momentum L act along the normal to plane of the electron orbit in the upward direction. Okay. Then let us suppose that time period of orbital motion of electron is T. Here that period of revolution of this electron that is taken is T. Then electron crosses any point on the orbit after every second or in 1 upon t time in 1 second. Frequency is taken is 1 upon t. Therefore, orbital motion of electron, that is equivalent to the current or circulating current, that will be equal to E upon T. T is time, E is charge. Therefore, period of revolution, time period of revolution, that is circumference upon velocity. As we know that velocity is equal to distance upon time. Here, distance is circumference. So, period of revolution, that is equal to circumference upon velocity. So, this T time period will be equal to 2 pi R upon V. So, the current I will be equal to E upon T. T is equal to 2 pi R upon V. So, this current will come out to be equal to E V upon 2 pi R. The area of the electron orbit, that is equal to pi R square. Therefore, the magnetic dipole moment of atom, that is given as M is equal to IA, that is equal to EV upon 2 pi r, that is into the area that is equal to pi r square. So m will be equal to EV r upon 2. So using this value, L is equal to m EV r, here it will be equal to, m will be equal to E upon 2 m E into L, or in the vector form, this magnetic dipole moment vector m will be equal to minus E upon 2 m E into L vector. Here this negative sign has been included for the reason that electron has a negative charge, and equation tell the magnetic dipole moment vector that is directed opposite to the angular momentum vector. Here is the angular momentum vector, then magnetic moment vector that will be in opposite direction. Then according to the Bohr's theory, angular momentum of electron in stationary orbit can have only those value which are integer multiple of h upon 2 pi. This is given by the Bohr, or you can say that L angular momentum that is equal to n h upon 2 pi, where n can have the value 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, etc. So on, so on. Using the value of L in the m is equal to E upon 2 m E multiplied by L, then magnetic moment will be equal to E by 2 m E into L, L that is equal to n h upon 2 pi, or m is equal to E upon 2 m E into L multiplied by n. So m will be equal to n into E h upon 4 pi m E. The value of this magnetic moment will be equal to n into E h upon 4 pi m E. Okay, this equation gives the magnetic moment of electron due to the orbital motion. Then the Bohr magneton. What is Bohr magneton? It is defined as the magnetic dipole moment associated with an atom due to orbital motion of electron in first orbit of hydrogen atom. First of orbit of hydrogen atom means n is equal to 1. It follows that EH upon 4 pi m is the least value of magnetic moment when n is equal to 1. This is the least value. This is the natural unit of magnetic moment, is called the Bohr magneton, and its value is equal to mu b, represented by mu b is equal to n E h upon 4 pi m E. Here the n is equal to 1, E is charge on electron, and h is Planck's constant, and m is the mass of electron. By substituting the values, 1 into 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19, this is the value of charge of electron, multiplied by h, h have the value, Planck's constant have the value, 6.626 into 10 to the power of minus 34, divided by 4 pi, pi have the value 3.14, and the mass of electron, that is 9.1 into 10 raising power of minus 31. Therefore the Bohr magneton will have the value 9.27 into 10 raising power of minus 24 ampere meter square. We know that in an atom, in addition to orbital motion, electron has got the spin motion also. Electron possesses the magnetic moment due to its spin also. The total magnetic moment of electron is a vector sum of the magnetic moment due to orbital and spin motion. Okay, then we come to the magnetic field. What is magnetic field? Space around the magnet or a current carrying conductor in which its magnetic effect can be experienced is called the magnetic field. And what is uniform magnetic field? The magnetic field in a region is said to be uniform if its magnitude of its strength, if the magnitude of strength and direction is same at all the point in the region. and our uniform magnetic field is represented by equidistant parallel region. SI unit of the strength of magnetic field, that is also known as the magnetic field induction or magnetic induction field or magnetic flux density, that have the unit Tesla or Weber per meter square. Strength of magnetic field is said to be 1 Tesla if charge of 1 coulomb when moving with velocity of 1 meter per second along the direction perpendicular to direction of magnetic field experiences a force of 1 Newton, that is a 1 Tesla. 1 Tesla is equal to 1 Newton per ampere per meter or 1 Weber meter square. In the CGS system, magnetic field have the unit of Gauss or Oersted, and 1 Gauss, that is equal to 10 raising power of minus 4 Tesla. And we summarize the whole of the today's module. We have discussed about the atom as a magnetic dipole. Let us calculate the magnetic dipole moment of atom due to orbital motion of electron. Suppose that electron of mass me and charge e revolve in circular orbit of radius r around the positive nucleus in anti-clockwise direction. Then angular momentum of electron due to orbital motion, that is given as L is equal to me vr. Suppose that time period of orbital motion is t and electron crosses any point on the orbit after every second or 1 upon t time in 1 second. Therefore, orbital motion of electron is equivalent to the current or circulating current I, that is equal to e upon t, or period of revolution, that is circumference upon velocity, that is equal to 2 pi r upon v. So the current I will be equal to ev upon 2 pi r. And according to the Bohr's theory, angular momentum of electron in stationary orbit can have only those value which are integer multiple of h upon 2 pi, or you can say that l is equal to n h upon 2 pi, and have the value 1, 2, 3, 4, so on. Then m will be equal to e upon 2 me multiplied by n h upon 2 pi, or m will have the value n e h upon 4 pi me. M will have the value n e h upon 4 pi me. This equation gives the magnetic moment of electron due to orbital motion. Then we have discussed the Bohr magneton. It is defined as the magnetic dipole moment associated with an atom due to orbital motion of electron in the first orbit of hydrogen atom. Or it follows that it has the value eh upon 4 pi m. That is the least value of the magnetic dipole moment and is called the Bohr magneton. And it has the value n e h upon 4 pi m e, substituting the values n is equal to 1, e is equal to 1.6 into 10 power of minus 19, h at the value 6.626 into 10 is power of minus 34, m e have the value mass of electron, that have the value 9.1 into 10 is power of minus 31. Then the value of the Bohr magneton that come out to be equal to 9.27 into 10 raising power of minus 24 ampere meter square. Okay, then last topic we have discussed about the magnetic field. What is magnetic field? Space around the magnet or current carrying conductor in which its magnetic effect can be experienced is called magnetic field. And what is uniform magnetic field? Magnetic field in a region is said to be uniform if its magnitude of strength and direction is same as that all at the all point in the region, and it is represented by equidistant parallel region, parallel lines. Strength of the magnetic field, also known as the magnetic field induction or magnetic field induction field or flux density, that had the value Tesla, that unit is a Tesla or Weber meter per meter square. And in the CGS system, a unit of the magnetic field is Gauss or Oersted, 1 gauss is equal to 10 is the power of minus 4 tesla. That was all for today, and next day we will study the properties of magnetic field line, earth magnetism and magnetic field element. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day.